Hello friends, welcome back to my channel IT Parivar. So guys, today I'm going to show you if you are trying to join any machine to the domain, and if you are getting Active Directory domain controller could not be contacted error. Let me show you. If you are getting this error, an Active Directory domain controller ADDC for the domain XYZ or whatever the domain you have could not be contacted. So I'll show you step by step all the possibilities, why you are getting that error, and why you are not able to join the machine to the domain. Okay, so there are multiple reasons you will get that Active Directory domain could not be contacted error. So I'll let you know in this video what will be the possibilities, what you need to check to fix that error. Okay, so that you can join your machine to the domain. So I'll let you know each and everything, so please don't skip the video. Okay, and if you have not subscribed yet my channel IT Parivar, so please subscribe, just to motivate me, just to support me. Okay, and click on the bell icon so that whenever I'll upload the new videos you will get the notification. Let's start now. So this is my client machine, and I am going to join this machine to my domain, that is itparivar.local. Let me jump on my domain controller. So this is my domain controller, and you can see here the domain name is itparivar.local. Okay, and the IP is 10.10.2 for this domain controller. Okay. Now I am trying to join this PC to the domain. Okay, so this is my Windows 10 machine, and I'll try to join this machine, and if you will see if we are getting that error. So what I am going to do here, I am going to click here on the properties of this PC. Okay, and you can see here there is a one setting, that is advanced setting. So you need to click if you have Windows 10 machine. If you have any other operating system like lower version, Windows 7 or XP, I think no one is using XP or Windows 7 now, so at least Windows 8 or Windows 10, right, you guys will use, I hope. So you need to click here on the advanced setting, and then this system properties window will be open. You have to click here on the computer name and go to the change, and here you need to enter itparivar.local. In same way you have to enter your domain name. Okay, and click on the OK button. Yes, you can see here you are getting, I am getting the same error, that is an Active Directory domain controller ADDC for the domain itparivar.local could not be contacted. Okay, so first of all we need to check, as I already told you, there are multiple reasons we can get this error, but first of all we need to check the system DNS configurations, right? So on this I am going to open network properties and cpa.cpl, and here this is my Ethernet. This is the this piece machine local area network, right? These are the VMwares and Wi-Fi. So I am going here to the properties and then go to the TCP IP version 4, select this, go to the properties, and first of all you have to check the preferred DNS server IP here. So you can see there is no any IP here. Okay, so here what we need to do, here we need to mention the primary DNS, or you can say domain controller IP address here, right? So as I already, here you can see the domain controller IP is 10.10.2 in my case. I am going to enter here 10.10.10.2. If you have any other domain controller or DNS server as an alternate server, you can enter here that server IP. Okay, I have only this server as a DNS or domain controller, so I am going to leave it is it as a blank. Okay, and saying okay, going to close this. Now we'll check. Now we'll go again to that this option. Just I'm going to say okay, and again I'll click here on the okay button. Yeah, now you can see it is prompting to enter the credential, right? So here I'm going to enter my domain, my administrator account. If you have any other domain admin account, you can enter here in same way. Going to say okay. Yes, you can see welcome to the itparivar.local domain. That means this machine is successfully joined to the domain. Here you can see also the itparivar.local, it's showing at on the internet. Okay, so I'm going to say here okay. It will ask to close all the programs and need to reboot the system. So for now I'm not going to reboot this system, because if I'll reboot this system, the recording will be stopped, and I have to show you something more, because except this there will be another reasons you will get this error. So the first reason is this, and if you will do this and after doing this you are getting the same error again, so what you need to check, you need to check the Windows firewall on your domain controller. So you can see I have opened here the server manager, and the Windows firewall status is off. You can click here, okay, and you can see the firewall setting is off. Okay, so you need to validate this, if the firewall setting is off, firewall is off or not. If firewall is on, then you need to off, because sometimes firewalls if firewall will be enabled, it will not allow to connect machines to the domain. Okay, so on the domain controller you have to check this setting, or you can say just you have to off the Windows firewall setting on the domain controller. Okay, the second the third option will be like maybe the DNS for your domain will not properly configured, and due to that you will get the error. So you have to open DNS setting here, okay, and expand this forward lookup zones. If you'll see this like msdcs itparivar.local or your domain name here and the other zones like here, and if the record is there like this start of authority name server record for your domain, that means it is okay. Otherwise if you'll not see here the name server or start of authority record for your domain, you need to create, or you have to create the SRV record. Okay, so I'll show you step by step. Here you can see service SRV service record. These are the service records, right? So coverage, LRAP, these all are here. If anything will be missed, right, in same way you have to create the SRV record for your domain. So this is the third reason, and the fourth reason will be, you can see the 10.10.10.2 is the my DNS or domain controller IP, and from here let me show you And this machine IP is also in same subnet 10.10.5. So sometimes if you are working in any company, in any organization, so network will be, maybe network will be different, right? Your, if your machine will be in different subnet and domain will be different subnet, so you need to check the connectivity with your network team. Okay, I mean the flow should be open, right? So how you can check that? Like, you have to go to the CMD, okay, and you can check few ports status, telnet space, your domain IP here. My domain IP is 10.10.2 and the port number is 53. This is DNS port, right? So we are going to check here the DNS port is or not. So I'm going to press here enter, and if you are getting this window like this, that means port is open, or you can say flow is open. You have to check all these ports in same way, like the DNS one. And let me show you one more port by doing telnet 10.10.10.2. So this is my domain controller. Again, I am saying this is my domain controller IP or DNS server IP. In same way, you have to enter your DNS IP and check the status, if flow is opened or not, network flow, right? Let me press again enter here. Yeah, you can see if you are getting this window for all these ports, that means network flow is opened. If you are getting any failed error, like network connection cannot be established or network connection failed, right, that means that network flow is not opened and you need to check with your network team to get this opened, right? So guys, these are the possibilities you may get that error, that is Active Directory domain controller could not be contacted during the domain join with the machine. Okay, so I hope this video will be helpful for you. Okay, so again, I'll request you to please subscribe, like, share with your friends, and if you have any query, please leave your comment. Thank you. Bye-bye.